Hello friends, welcome back to Engineering Today, and we're back with some latest and interesting updates for you. First, we'll discuss a Starship update, followed by Starlink's in-flight connectivity. Then we'll look into New Shepard's first winning bidder, and at the end we'll take a look at the Federated Quantum System. So let's begin today's space updates with SpaceX's Starship taking over Starlink launches. The Interplanetary Transport Vehicle of SpaceX, i.e. Starship, will take some time to become safe and reliable enough to launch humans in space. On the other hand, it's quite probable that SpaceX will move on to launch of Starlink satellites aboard Starships after it successfully completes its orbital flight tests. Elon Musk has repeatedly stated that they're planning to launch Starlink satellite constellation, in fact, large Starlink constellation, in a single launch. Musk recently tweeted on the 10th of June 2021 that Starlink missions will move to Starship. From Musk's statement, it's quite clear that Starship will eventually replace Falcon 9 from the workload of launching these satellites. Since the initiation of Starlink launches 2 years back, SpaceX officials and executives have explained that they'll shift their launcher vehicle from Falcon 9 to Starship. Though booster and fairing of Falcon 9 are reusable, but the second stage's Falcon 9 rocket couldn't be recovered. As a result, it's partially reusable. But as Starship will be fully reusable, it will reduce the cost per launch, becoming a cheaper option for SpaceX with larger carrying capacity. Starship, upon proving reliability, became a more viable option as it's made of stainless steel rings, which are much cheaper than the carbon composites earlier planned to be used for building Starships. According to a report, the cost of building Starship may become much cheaper than building Falcon 9 or Falcon Heavy, with development in production. According to SpaceX, the cost of each Starlink satellite is nearly $250,000, so it's quite probable that they may include some Starlink satellites in Starship during the initial stages of orbital test flight, despite having a good chance for failure. Starship launches till now are estimated to cost 5 times more than a partially expendable Falcon 9 launch. Yet, owing to the bigger launch capacity in comparison to Falcon 9, the per-satellite launch cost of Starlink missions on Starship will become much more nominal. Gwynne Shotwell, COO of SpaceX, has stated earlier that one Starship could deploy nearly 400 Starlink sats, which easily covers more than 6 launches of Falcon 9. SpaceX has also future plans to expand their Starship, which would further decrease the launch cost per Starlink satellite. Moving on to our next update, SpaceX's Starlink is on its way to provide in-flight internet. At present, the in-flight connectivity is provided by the satellites deployed in geostationary orbit. Due to greater distance from Earth's surface, the latency is not so good. SpaceX's Starlink satellites are placed in low Earth orbit, thus they can provide in-flight connectivity with much better latency. SpaceX will surely revolutionize the in-flight connectivity market if they enter into that service. At a panel discussion held on the 9th of June in the Connected Aviation Intelligence Summit, Jonathan Hofeller, SpaceX's VP of Starlink and Commercial Sales, said, "We're in talks with several of the airlines. We have our own aviation product in development. We've already done some demonstrations to date and are looking to get that product finalized to be put on aircraft in the very near future." This means SpaceX has already taken a step to provide in-flight internet to passengers with their Starlink satellite constellation. It's now for us to see within how many days SpaceX gets ready with a permission to start this service. For the past 1 year and 4 months, SpaceX has been working on aeronautical terminals that have advantages of controlling all aspects of their vertically integrated constellation. Back in 2020, SpaceX had also planned to test Starlink internet on Gulfstream jets. Thus, SpaceX has progressed a lot. With the release of news of SpaceX's entry into this market, the stock price of Gogo, an in-flight connectivity provider, has dropped by more than 11%. Due to the present COVID pandemic situation, airline travel is less, leading slash in the revenue earned by providing in-flight connectivity. In 2020, Gogo sold their in-flight internet business to Intelsat to make up for their losses. During testing of 60 Starlink version 0.9 satellite prototypes, SpaceX successfully delivered bandwidth of more than 600 megabits per second to a single military aircraft in flight. On the other hand, Gogo terminals currently provide speeds of 70 plus megabits per second, with major latency complaints. Other SpaceX competitors like OneWeb and Amazon are also present, but OneWeb is far behind in completing their constellation, and Amazon is yet to launch their satellites first. Thus, SpaceX is the only one ready with near-complete technology. Let's take a look at our next update based on Blue Origin's new Shepard first seat selling for $28 million. On the 12th of June 2021, Blue Origin wrapped up their competition spanning over 2 weeks with the sale of first seat of their new Shepard launch vehicle in a live auction. The bidding initially started at $4.8 million. Within 7 minutes, the bid got raised to $28 million and was finalized. Ariane Cornell, Blue Origin's Director of Astronaut and Orbital Sales, said after the auction, "How exciting was that? $28 million. The whole Blue Origin team cannot wait to meet our first customer." According to a report, the total payment for the seat, comprising the buyer's premium, worth 6%, will be rounded to nearly $29,680,000. As stated earlier, the winning bid amount will now be donated to the Club for the Future, nonprofit organization of Blue Origin. This Club for the Future is working to inspire future generations to take up careers in science, technology, engineering, and mathematics, commonly known as STEM, and also to help invent the future of life in space. Blue Origin said that they will reveal the name of the winning bidder very soon. At present, New Shepard launch has three passengers, the winning bidder of the auction, Jeff Bezos' brother, Mark, and Bezos himself. One more passenger will take part in the New Shepard launch, whose name is not announced yet. This New Shepard launch is taking place on the time period of the 52nd anniversary of the Apollo 11 moon landing. It's also a matter of glory for the winning bidder to become one of the first space tourists to fly just above the Kármán line. The winning bidder will now have to sign a liability waiver and undergo training before the flight. Blue Origin will also assess the winner's ability to fly. The July 20th flight will be the first crewed flight and overall 16th flight of the New Shepard vehicle. 15 earlier uncrewed test flights were carried out with this vehicle. According to the flight schedule, the launch will be carried out from Launch Site 1 near Van Horn in West Texas. After 2 minutes and 45 seconds from liftoff, the New Shepard crew capsule will separate from the first stage at 67 km altitude, and then the capsule will continue to ascend to 100 km. Then the capsule will fall back to Earth, later deploying parachutes to slow the descent. Today's last update is governments allied for Federated Quantum Encryption Satellite Network. Our kit, a British startup, is developing a quantum system known as the Federated Quantum System for commercial customers. They'll use this quantum technology to protect and preserve data from rapidly increasing developed cyber attacks. The United States, Japan, Italy, Belgium, Austria, and Canada are partnering together with the United Kingdom to promote a satellite-based quantum technology encryption network. According to a report, the cost of the project would be approximately $70 million if it comprises manufacturing of one designed satellite by 2023. Within a decade's time, the partners can buy a fully developed version at nearly $250 million. Under this system, fighter jets, military ground units, command and control centers would be able to share communications more securely across a multi-country protected network. The companies which will take part are Northrop Grumman of the US, British Telecom BT, Japanese investment firm Sumitomo, Austrian quantum technology startup QTL, Italian technology groups Leonardo, the Canadian and Belgian subsidiaries of aerospace company Honeywell and defense technology firm Kinetech. Our kit is raising $400 million in the space industry's latest SPAC deal. According to the deal, they will support the launch and construction of two satellites in 2023 to protect the network against increasing hacking cases. Our kit is merged with Centricus Acquisition Corp., special purpose acquisition company. Their combined value is $1.4 billion. Our kit plans to make the first version of their quantum cloud software available by July. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting. And kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.